We're here in the green room with Dan Rudiger. Rudy, nice to meet you.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, Rudy's fine.
Okay.
Yeah.
You look at the favorite sports teams of Americans.
Mm-hmm.
New York Yankees, Notre Dame, even look at a team like the Manchester United. We like to root for the winners, and yet there's something about the underdog.
Right.
What is about the underdog that resonates with so many sports fans?
I think that's why Notre Dame is such a connection to the family when I grew up. The underdog type of feeling, coming back, not supposed to win, you're not supposed to be here, it isn't for you. That connection, people fight back, they get that little, I call it a chip, I belong here too attitude. And they fight a little harder with passion, and they have attitude, and a good attitude. So the underdog is America. That's what America is built from, the underdog, and people relate to that. So when you get knocked down, you get up.
Mm-hmm.
Remember the movie Rocky?
Yeah.
Wonderful film, and that's what inspired me to do the movie Rudy.
With you, it's you're following your dreams, and then you've always had the people who said that these dreams aren't going to happen, they're not possible. But when you're making the movie, something there's a different kind of people that were involved, people who bought into your dream but wound up exploiting them.
You have to deal with it as you grow through it. You have a lot of trust in life. And when you trust people, you don't verify what their intentions are, and you find with that, and you gotta move. Mm-hmm. You just gotta keep moving around and don't look back. But Hollywood's an interesting personality. There's a lot of dreamers out there, and there's a lot of people who put things together. Very creative people, I love that. You tell them a story, and they could put that story together. Where I could tell a story, it'd take me an hour, they could take a minute, because they know how to do the composites and embellishments to make a story work. Mm-hmm. And that was what Rudy, for 10 years, trying to get the movie made for mm-hmm. 10 years, trying to put that thing in a presentation that didn't take that long to explain.
You know, in the book you mentioned about Hollywood, you say that there are a lot of dreamers in
mm-hmm.
Hollywood, but there aren't a lot of doers. What separates the two?
Passion.
Okay.
They don't go for the money. They go for the belief in the project. Or if they want to become an actor, they pay their dues.
Mm-hmm.
If they want to become a director, they pay their dues. I mean, that means they become the craft service person, whatever they need to do on set, or they help wardrobe. But they're around and always learning.
Mm-hmm.
My great example now, watching Jon Favreau
mm-hmm.
do that on set when he was brought in, TriStar casting him as D-Bop in the movie, and he never left set. Never left set. He was always talking about what he was going to do, what he wanted to do, and even when we did post-production, he was around it. Always around it because he wanted it. Then he became a wonderful director and actor, as you know, but that was his dream. But he needed a break in life, a chance,
mm-hmm.
and he got it, and he didn't leave it go. And that's another thing. Once you get in that door, you don't look back. You don't go back. That's the chip I'm talking about. You never want to go back, so you fight to stay there.
All right. Fight like a champion.
Yeah, man.
Thanks. Sir.